The Digital Competence Framework has four main parts, each with a number of elements. Knowledge and skills build cumulatively as pupils progress year by year. Producing is about creating all kinds of things, beginning with planning and research, then producing the item, and after that, looking at how well it does what it was supposed to do and ways of improving it. Let's see examples of the elements in practice.
I'm in year five and I create things. I start with a plan, look things up on the internet, and then away I go. Or so I thought. Because I hear that fake things are everywhere on the internet, and just believing the first thing you see can be a bad idea. So I've been shown how to search properly and check that the stuff I find and use is valid. After that, I can make whole digital creations, say about castles with video, pictures, animations like this, all sorts. As I go, I ask others in my class if my ideas work and try things out on them before taking it to my teacher. Or worse, my dad. He loves castles.
I'm in year 10 and I take producing to a new level. I feel like a pro. In my car design project, I used all sorts of software to build a multimedia project that was shown to the physics and math groups, so I had to make sure it was referenced and built on good information. I can even design and create computer models that mimic world issues, like how diesel cars will sell against hybrids and petrol over the next 10 years, and what that might mean for exhaust emissions. It's a changing world, and I'm changing with it.
There's clearly a lot to learn under each strand of the Digital Competence Framework. Lessons will evolve as new software and situations arise. Ideas for activities and lessons can be found in the framework. Often, teachers combine several elements in one project and sometimes several subject areas, covering various requirements of the framework in one logical swoop. Digital competence resources can be found on Hub, or for more information, go to www.gov.wales/curriculum for Wales.